victims here were not just faceless targets for a deranged gunman in a movie theater, but they may have been murdered for who they were, for how they worship, perhaps for the color of their skin or the sound of their names. They were the members of the Sikh community here in Oak Creek, Wisconsin.
Last Sunday, I woke up like any other teenager. First thing I did, picked up my phone, went straight to Facebook, a great social network where I saw our people have been shot.
I received a text message. I was working at Rite Aid on my Sunday job. Every Sunday I'm there working. And I was at work, it was about 10:30, maybe 11 o'clock in the morning. I glanced at my phone just because I was waiting on the next customer to pull up. And I saw a message saying that Gurdwara is held up in a different state.
At a temple just down the block from where I'm standing right now, preparing for Sunday services, when authorities say an Army veteran named Wade Michael Page appeared, took out a 9mm pistol, and opened fire.
For that next like 3 hours or so, this is probably the hardest time of my life because I was sitting there on my job, couldn't even walk out in some other state so far away. Like, my brothers and sisters were in need. Like, they're getting punked, they're getting shot at, they're getting killed. I don't know if anybody's dead yet.
I think it'll be very important for us to reaffirm once again that in this country, regardless of what we look like, where we come from, who we worship, we are all one people. And we look after one another, and we respect one another.
And that's when I felt proud. Not to say I'm just a Sikh, but to say I'm a Sikh American. Because it's an American who went, shot him down, put his life on the line for all of us. So that's why we're here today at this vigil, to show other people that it's not Sikhs, Hindus, Muslims that are targeted. It's us as Americans that are targeted. Americans fight for Americans.
I feel like God hand-picked that Gurdwara. The reason for that being is they had so many strong individuals. As you could see, like, every single person that gave an interview there was right on the money. They educated about Sikhism to the fullest. That hand-picked Gurdwara has shown so much strength. They showed the world, like, what Sikh he is. Even all the news stations, all the reporters have been shocked. Like, how could these people have a smile on their face still? They're not even crying on TV. They're not even fazed at all. They're still saying, like, God bless the guy. He had so much hate in him. God bless him. Hopefully God can take care of him, you know? Nobody else would do that. Nobody else ever, because there's so much rage, but our people are still have open arms policy to everybody.
Thank you everyone for coming today. It's an honor to be with so many esteemed representatives of different cultures, nationalities, religions. It's a tribute to Sacramento and Northern California that in a time of tragedy, we come together in such a powerful way and make a powerful statement here in front of the Capitol.
Good evening, my family. My name is Reverend Michael Moran. I'm with the Spiritual Life Center community here in Sacramento. Since the events of last week, my heart was broken over the senseless tragedy, and tonight my heart is very open and very hopeful as I see all of us coming together to stand for peace as family. So many of the previous speakers have said everything that I wanted to say, and one of my Sikh friends in Kansas City sent me this, and I'll just share this. The Sikhs among us will recognize it as coming out of your holy writings. You'll know the source, but he sent me this quote and also a prayer, and I think it's very appropriate for tonight. God judges us according to our deeds, not the clothes that we wear. Truth is above everything, but higher still is truthful living. Know we attain God when we love, and only victory endures in consequences of which no one is defeated. Tonight we stand boldly for peace and nonviolence in our communities, in our country, and in our world. And on behalf of the Spiritual Life Center community, I share this prayer that my Sikh friend sent. Lord, teach us to make peace with all that surrounds us. May we reflect on the meaning and shape our universe and nurture it with prayer, sacrifice, and inspiration of the great souls. May our labors and prayers converge to create a beautiful canopy of dignity, equality, justice, and abiding friendship for all living beings under the heavens to live in peace. May the entire creation move forward now in solidarity, oneness of spirit and purpose, and together shape and inherit a legacy worthy of God and humankind, where peace is not just a dream, but a reality. Om Shanti, Salam, Shalom, peace.
My thoughts have been that, as tragic as it is, it has been an opportunity for America to learn a lot more about Sikhism. Clearly, I wasn't born as a Sikh. I was born and raised as a Christian, but I adopted the Sikh faith because of a number of things, but I really love the tenets, the basic tenets that it stands for, which is equality, working by the sweat of your brow, sharing your earnings with others, being kind, compassionate, and caring to all. For people that don't know about the Sikh faith, Sikhs don't proselytize. So one of the unfortunate things is that a lot of people don't know what Sikhism stands for. If they truly understood that they stand for peace, for love, for compassion and kindness, I don't think they would have the same reaction. I would hope that Sikhs would turn to others and help to start educating America about what its basic tenets are, because there's a lot in common that we have with our fellow human beings and fellow Americans.
Despite what has happened, I still am quite hopeful. I don't feel fearful about the entire thing, because as a lot of people have stated, it is an opportunity to open up dialogue and to educate the public at large about what Sikhism is, which, interestingly, it's the fifth largest religion in the world, I believe, but still people don't know what a Sikh is. And hopefully people will now become more educated and there will be more love and understanding.
As a brown Indian girl, one of the hardest things to do is be different. But at the same time, with the same token, one of the most beautiful things is that I'm different. I'm diverse. So to any kid out there that has a gupti on his head or wears a turban or has a beard, hold your head up high, because it might be tough now. But if you embrace the fact that you have the ability to educate other people, tell them what our culture is about, tell them what other cultures are about, why diversity is so important, you will realize that this melting pot of America is what it is because you are different. I'm different. The guy next to me is going to be different, and that's why America is what it is, because we're all different.